Hello everyone, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo. Friends, today we are going to learn a concept that is known as BidAsk spread formula. BidAsk spread is useful not in terms of only in bonds, but it is also used in forex. So let's get into the nitty-gritty of this particular topic. As you can see, BidAsk spread, it's written difference between the price of the seller ask and the price of the buyer's bid for. The bid-ask spread is the difference between the bid price of the security and ask price. Okay, that's called the offer price. So it represents basically the difference between the highest price that a buyer is willing to pay for a security and a lowest price that a seller is willing to accept. So it's basically a transaction that occurs either when a buyer accepts the ask price or a seller takes the bid price. In a simple terms, I can say a security will trend upward in a price when the buyer outnumbers the seller. So as the buyers bid the stock higher, conversely a security will trend lower in prices when the sellers outnumbers the buyer, and as the supply of demand imbalance will force the sellers to lower their offer price. So the bid ask spread is a very important consideration for most investor when trading securities, since basically it is hidden cost incurred when trading any financial instrument, stocks, bonds, commodities, futures, options, and foreign exchange. Let's see what are the spread considerations. See, there are following number of points that needs to be borne in mind with regards to bid ask spread. Spreads are determined by liquidity, so as well as with supply and demand for a specific security. The most liquid or widely traded security tend to have a narrower spreads as long as there is no major imbalance between the supply and demand. If there is a significant imbalance and lower liquidity, the bid-ask spread will expand substantially. So spreads on the US stock have narrowed since the advent of the decimalization in 2001. Prior to that date, most US stocks quoted in the fractions of 1:16 of the dollar, that is close enough to 6.25 cents. So most stocks now trade at the bid-ask spread well below the level. Bid-ask spreads, it represents a cost that is not always apparent to the novice investors. While spread cost may be relatively insignificant for investors who do not trade frequently, they can represent a bigger cost for active traders who make numerous trader daily. Spreads widen during the steep market declines because of the supply demand imbalance as sellers hit the bid and the buyers stay away in anticipation of the lower price. As a result, the market makers, they widen the spread of, and that is only because of the two reasons. The first, to mitigate the higher risk of loss during the volatile times, and second, dissuade the investors from trading during such times. And as a larger number of the trades increases, the risk to the market makers of being caught on the wrong side of the trade. Now let's get into the bid-ask spread formula. Bid-ask spread is a very important consideration in the stock trading, and here is the bid-ask spread formula that you can use to calculate the spread. So what is exactly the bid-ask spread? It is basically the ask price of the security less the bid price of the security. So I can say the bid-ask spread is equal to, you can say, the ask price of the security less the bid price of the same security. This is basically the formula for the bid ask spread. See, remember, the ask price will always be higher. Ask price will always be higher than the bid price. A very simple way to think that bank will always sell any security or forex at a higher price and will buy at a lower price. The difference is their profit. So the ask, that is the offer price, and the bid, that is the purchase price. So the offer price has to be greater than the purchase price, as simple as that. Let's take and get into one example, a practical example, okay, that will really help you to get into the nerve of this particular concept. Let's go into the example. Let's say Tim decides to buy few stocks with the excess savings he has. His friends Brown is long-term investors. Brown asks Tim to find out the spread of the company M before he invests into it. And Brown says that understanding bid-ask spread will help Tim in future investments. So Brown has provided the following details. As you can see, the bid ask on the assumed one of the stock is close enough to 100 and the ask price is 102. Since Tim is a very new investor, he's a novice investor, he doesn't understand, I mean, what the spread is. So he finds out the formula and applies it. And in one go, he's able to find out the spread of the stock of the company. Here, the calculation will be spread is equal to the ask price of the stock. You say spread will be equal to the ask price. I'll just write spread over here. The ask price of the stock less any bid price of the same stock. Less bid price of the same stock. Okay. So let's put some numbers over here. It will be 102 less 100. That will give us the other answer comes as 2. So our answer is spread is equal to 2. So as per Tim, the spread of a stock of a company of M is 2. Now let's get into the explanation of the BidAsk spread formula. If you want to make your mark as an investor, you need to know the basic of the stock trading. Spreading is a concept that every investor needs to understand. When a stock is sold, it has two parties. One is called buyer, another is called sellers. The buyers tell the sellers that they are ready to pay a price for a stock. We call it what? A bid price. So the seller also tells the buyer that they can sell the stock at a price. So the price sellers ask is always little higher than the price of the buyer are ready to pay. And the price sellers ask for a stock is called the ask price. In bid ask formula, we find out the difference between the price of the seller ask and the price of the buyer's bid in this particular example of Reliance Industries Limited. Now, as we can see from the bid ask spread example of Reliance Industries, for a buy quantity of close enough to 47, the bid price is 925.30. And as you can see, whereas the ask price is close enough, the bid price is 925.25 and the sell, that is the offer price or the ask price, is 925.30. So the bid ask, that is the offer price less the bid price, okay, will give us the bid ask spread, that is 0.05. So as an investor, you may ask why the seller always ask for the higher price of a stock. It is because they keep a little profit for themselves. But that's not the only thing that's included in the ask price. Along with the commission of the broker, the spread also includes number of fees. Got it? And that fees will boost up the value of the bid ask spread. Remember one thing. See, the spread on the US stock have really narrowed since 2001. And the spread has widened during the steep market declines because the supply demand imbalance as a seller. And it hits the bid. The buyers stay away in the anticipation of the lower price. So as a result, the market makers, they widen the spread for the two reasons. First, to mitigate the higher risk of loss. And second, as we know, that the larger number of the trades increase the risk to the market makers of being caught on the wrong side of the trade. Now, most forex trading at a very retail level is done using a great deal of leverage, because of which spread cost a percentage of the trader's equity, and it can be quite high. For a quick calculation of the cost of a spread as a percentage of your margin or equity, simply multiply the spread percentage by the degree of leverage. For example, if the spread in our case was, let's say, 5 pips, that is the 5 points, so we can say we just need to add those 0.05 value in that particular case. Let's take one more example and get into the core of this concept. Now consider the example of an equity option trade. Let's say you buy a short-term call option on a stock XYZ as you are bullish on it. So the stock is trading at, let's say, 31.39, and this is the ask price, that is 31.40. And the 1 month call are trading at, let's say, 32. And 1 month, $32 call are trading at 0.72 and 0.73. So over here, the bid ask spread, okay, in this case is just a penny. but in a percentage term, it is sizable to close enough to 1.37. So over here, the underlying stock is also trading within the penny spread, but in percentage terms, the spread is much more smaller at a rate of 0.032% because of the higher price of the stock as compared to the option. An option trader, however, is unlikely to be deterred by the significantly higher spread percentage on a call, since the main motivation for buying a call option is to participate in the underlying stock advance while putting down the fraction of the amount required to buy the stock. Now, let's get into some more details on this. First, bid-ask spread tips. Use limit orders. An investor or trader is generally better off using the limit orders, which allows one to place a price limit for a purchase or sale of a security, rather than the market orders, which are filled at the prevailing market price. In fast moving markets, the use of the market order can result in higher price than desired for a purchase and a very lower price for the sales. For example, if a prevailing price of a security that you wish to buy is, let's say, 9.95 and it is $10. Okay, rather than buying a stock at 10, you could consider bidding at 9.97 for it. So while the possibility of getting the stock 3% cheaper is offsetted by the risk that the stock may move in the price, so you can always change your bid price if required. So at least you will not be buying the stock at 10.05 because you entered the market order and stock moved up in the interim. Second, avoid the liquidity charges. The use of the limit orders also enhances the liquidity in the marketplace. So this enables you to avoid the liquidity charges imposed by most of the electronic communication networks for using the market liquidity, which occurs when you use the market orders executed at the prevailing bid ask prices. Evaluate the spread percentage. That's the third thing. As the example earlier demonstrated, bid ask spreads can be quite significant if you are using margin or leverage. Evaluate the spread percentage, since the 5% on a $10 stock is much greater in percentage terms than a 5% spread on the $40 stock. Fourth, shop around for the narrowest spreads. This is especially applicable to the retail forex trader who may not have the luxury of the 1% spread available to the interbank and institutional forex trader. Shop around for the narrowest spread among many forex brokers who specializes in retail clients to improve their odds of trading success. So, conclusion, pay attention to the bid-ask spread, since it is the hidden cost incurred in trading any financial instrument. This is why bid-ask spread can also erode the trading profits and aggregate losses. So the impact of the bid-ask spread can be mitigated by using the limit orders, evaluating the spread percentage, that was the second thing, and the shopping around the narrowest spread. Thank you.